as a designer and a star, when you work closely together, it's this magic that happens, you know, and it's really, it's a very intimate relationship.
Clothes can communicate what dialogue doesn't.
The costume is the character. You take the character out of the costume and what do you have?
The give and take and obviously the exchange between a creative person as an actress and a creative person as a costume designer can be amazing if it's the right synergy.
You get an ooh and an ah when you walk out and haven't even opened your mouth to sing or say a word. You know something's working.
It is really a human connection. You know, these looks, these moments that we keep in our collective consciousness.
You dress somebody and it's really successful and all of a sudden they're realizing they look better than they've ever looked.
I think when you go to a designer to participate in a film, to some degree, you go to the designer because you want that designer's point of view.
I think what makes the collaboration between a designer and a star work so well is when they're both attuned to the final outcome.
The muse should inspire the designer, and the muse should be inspired by the designer as well.
In looking for muses, I feel like they find you. They have to come into your life and sort of offer a new way of looking at your work.
For me, Ms. Tyson became that, and I became that for her. And, you know, we see that in other iconic relationships like Catherine Deneuve and Yves Saint-Laurent, and certainly Audrey Hepburn and Givenchy.
I think about Adrian and Joan Crawford, or Adrian and Jean Harlow, Bob Mackie and Cher.
I never thought about searching for a muse. You do your very best on everybody, and it has to be right for what they're doing. As a costume designer, you know, you just have to think about it. She's gonna dance, she's gonna sing, she's gonna waltz. It's really like a science.
When we're thinking of actresses like Dietrich and Garbo and Hepburn, they were women who asserted their own personal style at a moment when the studio system really was a star factory.
These women knew their power. I mean, they were owned by studio systems, but they had to fight and build their power. There's a great history with Hollywood and this dialogue that started to get created and collaborations with the great European designers.
I'm so sick of everything being about France and the French. Unfortunately, in the Western world, it is.
Well, the 1950s marked an era known as the Golden Age of Couture, when all eyes were on Paris, and the couture that was coming out of Paris was aspirational, almost in the same way that film costume design had always been a bit aspirational.
It wasn't just Hollywood. I mean, all of America was looking to French couture. The designers in New York were downright copying.
What better than the amazing Hollywood system to be, you know, incorporated? And when you have great icons of beauty, Dietrich, Audrey, you know, these are amazing people that were the fashion plates at the time.
Once you've got a winning combination, why mess around with it?
The greatest pairing of all, and I think it's without peer really, was between Audrey Hepburn and Givenchy.
Audrey was so smart that she knew exactly how she should look. She went to meet Givenchy on her own. He thought it was going to be Catherine Hepburn. And she walked in and he went, oh.
Everything we know about Hepburn's style really comes from him. And of course, her feedback and insight and guidance as well. But that was pure magic.
It's hard to think about Audrey Hepburn now without the visual that Givenchy created for her. I mean, it's become her character on and off the screen. The same with Catherine Deneuve and Yves Saint Laurent. You know, their relationship very much was about the films they did together, but it transcended the film and it became a part of their lives. That's really when you know it's the right fit. And as Catherine Deneuve would call it, the love affair she had with Yves Saint Laurent.
C'est une jolie robe. On dirait une collégienne précoce.
Catherine Deneuve in Yves Saint Laurent and Belle de Jour, there's a study in character.
When the character presents oneself, the costume certainly tells us who this character is. Is she a good girl or a bad girl? Except in the case of Catherine Deneuve in Belle de Jour, who dressed very quietly and politely, and then we know she had an afternoon job.
That character, of course, is this housewife who decides to be a prostitute.
Vous êtes gentille et fraîche. C'est le genre qui plaît ici.
So there's references to a little bit of the naughty, even when she's still in these perfectly classic Yves Saint Laurent pieces. And that, in addition to And God Created Woman, is a reference point for fashion today. Absolutely one of the most influential movies.
De quoi as-tu peur?
De moi.
And God Created Woman was just this explosion of Brigitte Bardot. Pierre Balmain, who was a famous French designer, did the costumes. There's a minimalism about Pierre Balmain. The red boat neck sheath dress. That dress could be worn today. And he brings forward a lot of the French style. She wears a men's pajama top, a shirt dress with a self tie in it. So it's these very basic pieces, but classic. And it too is one of the most influential movies on the fashion industry.
C'est dangereux. Il pourrait plus m'oublier.
Je prends le risque.
Actresses can be demanding, of course, on what they want to wear, and should be within reason.
Isn't there some way we could let it plunge a little in front?
When starring in the 1950 film Stage Fright, Marlene Dietrich famously said, "No Dior, no Dietrich." And that's because in 1950, Christian Dior was the absolute pinnacle of the fashion world.
No use trying to stop me. I'm going on tonight.
Marlena was always playing the seductress. Whether she was a prostitute or she was just running a nightclub or whatever, you always took a second look at Marlena and you said, oh, look at her.
You really do see these quintessential elements of Dior's aesthetic peppered throughout the film, which means that the investment in bringing aboard Christian Dior was very much worth it.
Black? Well, yes, of course. How clever of you to remember, darling.
As a fashion historian, I am particularly drawn to the designer movie star collaborations that led to influencing fashion off screen as well as on.
With Bonnie and Clyde, Theodora Van Runkle's costumes, so influential.
We rob banks.
Theodora Van Runkle was a close friend and mentor. She didn't know the impact her costumes would have on a generation.
I bet you're a movie star.
The costumes and Faye Dunaway. That's all you needed. Beret sales went through the roof when that movie came out.
I remember Theodora saying that she and Faye Dunaway came into Paris and they were greeted by 1,000 young women wearing a beret.
Shh, you're a nugget.
I think it's difficult to have comparable pairings in this post-studio system era, where contracted costume designers and contracted actors are no longer guaranteed this extended collaboration.
Hollywood shifted in the 1970s moving forward, where it's less about the star costume designer partnership and much more about the costume designer director partnership.
A muse helps you give a personality to the look. And it's just like any relationship. It's about trust. It's about vision. It builds as time goes.